I feel the Holy Ghost. As soon as I walked in here, I got goosebumps on me, man. Right there. I mean, I feel the glory of God in this place. I mean, you love Jesus with all your heart. Woo! Come on, crank it up a little bit. Charles, are y'all ready? Man, I don't know what's going to happen tonight, but something great's going to happen in this place. Woo! Yeah! 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 How many of you want to see the glory of God tonight in this place? I mean, you love God with all your heart. Woo! You just love God with everything that's within you. You worship Him with all your heart. Yeah. Yes. Jesus. 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 Jesus.
Excitement there this evening.
Man, I walked in, Chief, and I started getting chills. Woo! All over me. I've just felt the glory of God when I walked in.
Always, always. Hey, Bishop, I want to tell you that, man, Brother Jimmy over there, Brother Jimmy came to my place Monday. That man ain't afraid to put a day's work in, can I tell you?
He's been with me all day.
Man, look, that's a good man.
He's a great man.
He showed me what work was about, reminded me when I was young.
And Mr. Jimmy's 53. Okay.
He's still a youngster.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Still a youngster. But I just wanted to say that because
that
brother came and the equipment broke down and he went back to manual. He said, I know how to do this.
That's awesome.
I'm old school, Chief.
Thank you, Lord.
Father God, we just want to thank you today, Lord. We want to thank you for all the Jimmys out there that are in our program and out there that aren't afraid to put in a day's work, Lord. We just want to thank you for the opportunity for this church to get to serve people like that, to give them an opportunity to grow and to heal, Lord. Father God, as we enter into this next season, coming into July, Lord, for the city, it will be a new budget year and a new fiscal year for us. We just pray for favor over the city of Baker, Lord.
Yes, we do.
We pray for its government and all of its people, Lord. And here at Miracle Place Church, it's one of our vows is to continue to pray for our government, for our city.
Yes.
And Father, we just ask for continued guidance for the leadership here as we continue to grow our ministry here, Lord, that you would continue to bless Bishop Ricky Sinclair, my friend, Lord, and give him all the wisdom, Lord. Give him all that he needs, all the fuel for his tank so he can sit here and provide for this great group of people that are us, Lord, the Miracle Place Ministries. Father God, thank you. Thank you for all you've done. Thank you for all you're going to do, Lord. And Father, we're always going to remember to give you all the honor, all the glory, and all the praise. And we accept it all in your precious Son, Jesus' name. And his people said, amen and amen.
Amen and amen. Come on, give the Lord a great big shout in this place. I just feel the glory of God in this place. Father, we just welcome your presence, your power, your glory. into this house tonight.
Yes.
Lord, we want you.
Yes.
We just simply want you, God.
Yes.
We ask you to speak to
yes.
every heart, every life, every person.
Yes.
Thank you for setting us free, Lord.
Every need, Lord.
We are no longer slaves to fear.
Say the name of
Jesus.
We're no longer slaves, but you have conquered the grave. You are here. Inhabits the praises of his people. Inhabit the praises of your bride. We are no longer slaves. He is conquered.
yourself when you were small. That wall is still there, but now that wall has become a wall of bondage, and you can't get in, and you can't get out, and you can't get over, and you can't get under. But God, God is here to break every chain, every self-imposed chain, every generational curse, every chain. Like a pet, you thought you had it under control. It was on a leash, you said. It does what I want it to do. It goes where I want it to go. But one day it fall back, and it was stronger than you thought. Hallelujah. You had made it stronger than you thought. Hallelujah. And it began to take over. Hallelujah. But God is here tonight to break every chain.
My biological father, okay? And after I was born, my mom split for a lot while for with somebody else, and I lived with my grandparents, and it kind of went like that most of my life. All right, my maiden name is King. My biological name is King. And I looked up earlier today, and one of the things about King was from the French. The King would give all orphans his title, King. Every orphan was named, you know, Jeannie King, okay? And they were the daughters and the sons of the King. The King took them under ownership. I thought, you know, I'll take that, man. That ain't a bad deal. God was speaking to my heart. He says, Ezekiel 16. Because I'm thinking about all this song and stuff, and you know, some chains people put on us. You know what I'm saying? Kind of like the rejection and the neglect and stuff like that brought some chains on me. But then some chains I owned, you know, the men I pursued, the dope I did, the things, the choices I made, I forged those chains. When you were born, no one cared for you. When I first saw you, your umbilical cord was uncut, and you had been neither washed nor rubbed with salt nor clothed. No one had the slightest interest in you. No one pitied you or cared for you. On that day when you were born, you were dumped out into a field and left to die unwanted. But I came by and I saw you there, says the Lord, covered with your own blood. And I said, live. And you thrive like a plant in the field. I don't care where you come from, what chains have been put on you by the people that you grew up around, or why people have burnt you throughout life or whatever, or by the chains that you have forged by your own hand. It doesn't matter. God is passing by tonight and he is speaking to you and he says, I'm calling you out of your blood right now and I am speaking life over you. And you will thrive. You will do what I created and caused you to do because you are not a mistake. Look, I might have been a surprise. I'm not going to say, you know, surprise. But God has ordered my steps and he's taken care of me all my life. And maybe things weren't always great, but it's all good because in the end, God has done me right. God has been faithful. And I'm telling you, his power's in this house tonight. I'm telling you, if you'll just let it down and let it go, God will do great and mighty things in your heart and your life. Because he's just that kind of God. It just doesn't matter. Amen? Y'all ain't feeling me. I'm telling you what. I'm up in here praising Jesus all by myself, Rick. All by myself, doggone. I'm still all by myself, just like when I was born. I can see it already. Let me tell you something, man. Let me tell you something. God's doing something great. He's doing something great in our spirits tonight. He's transforming us. He's taking us from place to place, from glory to glory. Hallelujah. Let me tell you what. He's raising up a generation. This world is crazy. They done lost their mind. You hear what I'm saying? But for every Ahab, there's an Elijah. Hallelujah. For every Herod, there's a John the Baptist. Hallelujah. And I'm telling you right now, you are not a mistake. God is doing something phenomenal. No matter what you think about yourself or what you think about God, your thoughts about him and your opinions about the Lord and all this, they don't negate the fact that God is real, that he's big, and that he will do what he says that he will do. We have to transform our thinking and our mindset to conform to his word. He doesn't conform to ours. Amen? I'm telling you, God is real in this house tonight. God is real, God is real, God is real. And he is an ever-present help in a time of need. Come on, give him praise in this house one more time. Yes. Yes, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. If you haven't been seated, you may be seated. How's everybody doing? I'm just all caught up in my own little thing over here, so excuse me. We got any guests in the house tonight? If you would, just raise your hand for me. Keep it up. Oh, yeah, a whole row. How's it going? Did you invite all these folks, my friend? Oh, look at you. Come on now. Well, it's so wonderful to have you here tonight. We'll have an usher get by and get you a card. If you wouldn't mind filling that out, and we'll take up our tithes and offerings in a minute. And if you wouldn't mind just dropping that in the bucket. Amen? Love to shake your hand after service. Anybody else? I don't want to miss anybody. No? We good? All right. Well, let's go look at our commercial break with NPC 77 News. I'll be right back.
Hey church, it's that time again for Christmas in July, and sometimes money is tight during the holidays like in November, December. So we do this program during the month of July, and we ask that the next time you're in Walmart, Dollar General, pick up a little $5, $10 Christmas gift for our Christmas Wish program that we have in December. Drop it in the box here. We're going to have it up the whole month of July, and we thank you for everything that you do for the kids and for Miracle Place Church.
Jumbo, welcome to Camp Kilimanjaro. This epic vacation Bible school program is filled with the adventure kids love and the evangelistic apologetics you trust. Every day, our kids are faced with choices. Will they choose wisely or foolishly? As your trekkers safari at Camp Kilimanjaro, they'll learn that true wisdom comes only from God. They'll take an epic expedition through the book of Proverbs to discover God's wisdom. Set your compass for Africa and an epic expedition at Camp Kilimanjaro.
Date by visiting miracleplacechurch.org. At this time, we'd like for you to silence all cell phones
and bring your children to their age-appropriate location and prepare your hearts to receive Bishop's message of grace.
Yep. I second that. All right. Everybody prepared to give tonight? Ready to bless the Lord? Amen. Father, we just come to you right now in the name of Jesus, and Lord, we lift up our gift before you tonight. Lord, I pray that you would just bless and cause your people to be highly favored in all areas of their life. Lord, I pray that they would walk in the power and the glory all times, Lord Jesus, as a light in this world. Father, I pray for those who are unable to give at this time, that you would speak peace to their heart, that you would strengthen and encourage them and bring them to a big place, Lord God, where they have plenty. Father, we just bless you right now. We just give you all the glory and honor in Jesus' name. Amen.
Guys, I'm so glad that y'all are with us tonight. This is Brother Ricky. Just greeting you and thanking God that you're with us tonight. I tell you, it's been a powerful night tonight. As I walked into the sanctuary tonight, I felt chills all over me in the glory of God. So right now, in the name of Jesus, we just take the glory of God that's in this place tonight, and we release God's presence and God's power right now into your houses, into your families right now. We're asking God, in your situation, whatever you're going through right now, we release the glory and the power of God to flow into you right this second, right now. Now, God, I just release healing, Lord, the healing virtue power of Christ. I release the authority of your kingdom right now into your people tonight. God, every person that's oppressed, God, that has a spirit of heaviness, God, we put on the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness, and we release the authority of God's kingdom and his power into your lives tonight. You'll never, 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 ever, ever, ever be the same again. We love you so much, and we speak God's blessing over your lives this tonight. Have a great, great, great night. And listen, don't go away. Got a great service for you. We always like to pray a little bit at the end too. So stay with us. God's going to do something supernatural. Get ready. The power of God is coming into your house. A lamb for every house. He's moving right now in the name of Jesus.
I'm not afraid to die.
Come on, give the Lord a great big shout. Oh, come on, you can do better than that. He is worthy. From the rising of the sun till the going down to the same, His name is worthy to be praised. Shout somebody. All right, let's jump into the Word of God. If you got your Bibles, Acts chapter 5, verse 26. And when you're there, say there. Okay, y'all moving. And when you're there, say there. All right, there. When you said there, something jumped in my spirit. My baby just leaped. Jehovah Shammah, the Lord God is there. How many of you want to go to a place called there and find God? Jehovah Shammah, the Lord God is there. Here's what the Word of God says. It says, then went the captain with the officers and brought them without violence. This is the apostles. For they feared the people lest they should have been stoned. And when they had brought them, they set them before the council, the Sanhedrin council, and the high priest asked them, saying, did not we strictly command you guys to stop preaching in that name, Jesus? Didn't we tell you that you guys are turning the world upside down? Listen, I got a message for the church today. How many of you know we need to turn the world upside down for the glory of God? We need to preach Jesus Christ. We need to release the authority of God's kingdom. Look at your neighbor and say, kingdom. It's all about kingdom. God's kingdom is the authority in planet Earth over the kingdom of darkness. And that's why it's about God's kingdom, because it releases God's power, His presence, and His authority. And here's what's happening with the disciples who have now become apostles. Jesus Christ has been crucified, right? He's ascended on high. He's seated at the right hand of God the Father now. The apostles have been filled with the Holy Ghost. Look at your neighbor and say, you need the Holy Ghost. And so now the authority and power of God is in them. How many of you know that when God lives in you, you got the authority? And so now what they're doing is they are preaching the glorious gospel of Jesus. The Sanhedrin Council, which is the Jewish leaders, are trying to snuff them out and keep them quiet. They thought they had gotten rid of the problem when they killed Jesus, but the problem is they've started multiplying. You know why? Because when Jesus Christ died, it released the disciples to step up to the plate and take the baton and run for the glory of God. How many of you know they had to step up? Are y'all out there? That's why people die in our families, and then the baton is passed to us, and we got to step up to the plate. I mean, you know you don't step up to the plate till you got to step up to the plate. Are y'all alive? And so now Jesus has been crucified. Jesus is risen from the dead. His disciples who have become apostles, who are the leaders of the church, are now preaching and teaching the Word of God. Peter's already been thrown in jail in Acts chapter 4, and the angel came and jail busted him out. How many of you know the Lord will just send an angel to just break you out of jail? Chains will fall off, gates will just open. The angel told Peter, man, get your shoes on, man, let's go. Be quiet, be quiet. We got to get out of here. Peter gets to the door. The rest of the disciples have been praying to deliver Peter out of jail. He's knocking on the door. The little girl runs in and says, Peter's at the door. They, oh, no, that must be an angel or somebody. Wait a minute. He's been praying for him to be delivered. And he's at the front. Oh, y'all out there. Finally, they got themselves together and opened the door. And there was Peter, man. He came in. But now here they're being put in jail again. And now it's not just Peter. Now many of the apostles, the Bible says the apostles are now put in jail. And so what's happened is the Lord has sent his angel again to jailbreak the apostles this time. How many of you need a get out of jail free card? Oh, shout. I hope nobody was watching on TV. All of them raised their hand. They need a... Jesus, what kind of church do we have here? We got newcomers. We got one that wouldn't even raise her hand up here. I just let her go. How many need a jail, a get out of jail free card, and half the church raised their hand? Oh my God, you're the kind of church I've been looking for all my life. You're radical for God. You're going to do something great for God. You ain't scared. If you're scared, say you're scared. If you're a man and you're going through a little something, all you got to do is say, mama, to me, mama, and we'll let you go home to mama. How many of you know that if we're going to do something great for God's kingdom, we got to be radical for God? We can't be scared. Man, somebody, we might just rub somebody a little wrong, man, and they just might get a little mad, a little persecution. All those that live godly shall suffer persecution. You ever read that scripture? Listen, and now here the apostles are in jail. The angel of the Lord comes and busses them out, and just before he lets them go, he says, now look, he says, I want you to preach this word called life in Jesus Christ at daylight at the temple. Wait a minute. I've been in jail for preaching, and you're telling me to go preach some more in the same temple so they can put me back in jail? How many of you know that you got to hear the voice of God even if it sounds crazy, even if it costs you a little something, even if it's a little sacrifice, even if it goes a little bit against the grain in your life? You got to do what God called you to do. If he says, preach the life of Jesus, you've got to preach the life of Jesus, girl. And guess what? Sure enough, daylight, an anointing came on the apostles. Imagine that. Man, y'all be praying for me. I'll be opening up for the mayor's prayer breakfast tomorrow. 7 o'clock, babe. I'm on the night shift, babe. So you know, how many of y'all on the night shift? Oh, don't. It's all right. You don't have to be a morning person around here. I said, how many of you know that somebody's got to cover at night while y'all are sleeping so you're up at daylight in the morning? You morning people. It's amazing how people will judge. Oh, you slept till 8 o'clock?
Well, you went to bed at 8:30.
Yeah. Well, I went to bed at 3 a.m. and you went to bed at 6. And now you're up at daylight with the birds chirping. And I'm still sleeping because I was covering last night, that night shift, while you were sleeping. I was covering us. Are y'all alive? And so here the apostles are. They're actually now back at the temple with the anointing of God, preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ. And now the Sanhedrin Council, the Jewish leaders, immediately go and they arrest them again and they bring them before the Sanhedrin Council. And look what's so cool is the Sanhedrin Council had Pharisees and Sadducees. They call them Sadducees because they were pretty sad. So I'm just teasing. All right, camera woman, you can't laugh too loud, it'll shake the camera. So And so the Sadducees, what's so cool about it is the Sadducees didn't really believe in, like, spirits. They didn't believe in angels. They didn't believe in resurrection. And how many of you know the angels are the ones that delivered the apostles out of jail? And they didn't really want to believe in healing and all of that. And listen, they're lining up people that are sick on the road that just want to get a glimpse of Peter's shadow. If just Peter's shadow will touch them on the highway, they'll get healed. Listen, they started preaching Jesus Christ. Are y'all out there? And in Jesus Christ, there's repentance for sins. He's the only way. He's the prince. He's the savior of the world. He's the healer. He's the deliverer. He's the one that'll set you free. By the way, he's the only one that can do it. Moses can't do it for you. You've been living according to Mosaic law, and all of y'all are still stuck up. You ain't done nothing for you. There ain't no power in law. Power comes from Jesus. Man, and the whole city's shaking, rocking, and reeling, man. Folks are running for healing, running for deliverance. Men are all out in the highways. And then when they get healed, they get delivered. They start saying, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Drove the religious leaders crazy. Are y'all out there? Those sanctimonious folks. You know, the ones with the long noses. A little bit better than you. I mean, you know, God will take the foolish things of the world and confound the wise. He'll take the weak. Come on now. You know why God will take somebody crazy like me? Because he gets all the glory. When you take somebody that ain't nothing, come on now, and you anoint them and they do something great, and they holler, God! God gets all the glory. He gets more glory out of a weak when he does one strong. Are y'all out there? God's looking for somebody that will lay their life down. God's looking for somebody that get radical for God. God's looking for somebody that ain't scared, that's ready to fight the good fight. Somebody that's going to go after God with all of their heart. Somebody that's not scared to worship God. Somebody that's not ashamed of the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. He said, if you be ashamed of me, y'all already know all the scripture. So if you'll be ashamed of him, he'll be ashamed of you when he comes in his Father's glory with all of the holy angels. Listen, let me tell you something. I am not ashamed of the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ because it is the power of God. Listen, I got something that's so good. Listen, you can be a millionaire today, a multi-billionaire. Listen, let me tell you something. I got something your money can't buy, honey. Listen, I got something government can't give you, baby. There ain't no government program can give you the power of Jesus. Ain't no salvation and no money. Ain't no salvation, no program, babe. I don't care how stuck up you are. I don't care how sanctimonious you are, baby. I don't care. Because when you got it, you got it. And you know how you got it? Because you're a worshiper. You're a lover. You're a chaser of God. You love God more than anything in all the world. And listen, you love him so much that you ain't ashamed. It don't matter who comes around you. You're still going to praise him. You're going to still give him glory. You're going to still love him. You're going to worship God no matter who's looking, who's watching. You're going to raise your hands to God. Oh, my God, those big hands. Wait, I feel funny raising my hands before God. Get those big shovels up. Get those shovels up. I bet you won't feel crazy when the police says stick them up. I bet you'll surrender then. I bet you'll make a touchdown. You want the referee to touchdown. Man, if you can do it on the football field, if you can do it for Mr. Policeman, how many in the... I mean, you know you can do it for the one that really counts. Yeah, really, really. Give him glory. Listen, the early apostles in the early church, radical, radical, radical. They had seen Jesus, and they were witnesses of him. they were filled with the Holy Ghost and with His power. That's what they said. They said, well, didn't we strictly forbid you not to? Who made you a doggone authority over me anyhow? That's what I told the Mormon one day when he came there. He says, what authority do you have to preach what you preach? I said, what authority do you have? My authority comes from God. I'm thinking about the Sanhedrin Council, man. Who are you? Who do you think you are? This is what one of the apostles said. He said, listen, he says, we ought to obey God and not man. We're going to be God pleasers, not men pleasers. We made a decision, babe. We made a decision. We ain't living for you. Go ahead. Listen, put me in jail. You can't eat me. Put me in jail again. Hey, look, let me tell you, you Sadducees, listen. The angel of the Lord broke us out. That's how we got out last night. You remember when you went to the penitentiary, you went to the jail, and your guards were still standing there in front of the cell, the bar cell that we were in, and the gates were still locked on the outside, and then you went to bring us in, and y'all looked in the cell, and nobody was there, but yet nobody saw anything? Mr. Sadducees, the Lord sent His angel and He delivered us. Are y'all out there? And immediately they put them outside of the little meeting they were having. And Gamaliel stood up and he was an authority in the law. He was respected by everybody on the council, probably 70, 72 on the Sanhedrin council. And he said, men, he says, first of all, put the apostles out. Let me talk to y'all private. And when the apostles went outside the meeting, he looked at the 70 or 72. And he says, I want you to take heed in your decision that you're about to make. He says, and here's the wisdom of God. He says, you remember that last little group that came through, about 400? And they were all preaching their doctrine. Remember what happened? The leader was killed and all the rest were scattered. It came to naught. He said, and then Judas rose up and he had a big following with him, and his teaching was all over, and you remember what happened to him? He ended up dead too, and his followers scattered. He said, men, be careful about the decision that you make concerning these men. If this thing be of God, then you will be found fighting against God Himself. But if this thing be not of God, like the last little groups that rose up, it'll dissipate and go away by itself. You ain't got to make no judgments here today. Let these guys go. And they said, Gamaliel, we like that advice. So let's go ahead and scourge them. Let's give them a good whipping. And then we'll let them go. And the Bible says after they were whipped. When's the last time y'all took a whipping for Jesus? When's the last time you shed some blood for Jesus? Man, it got quiet in here. I can hear a pin drop. And the Bible said that they rejoiced because they were counted worthy to suffer for Jesus Christ. Guys, how many of you know? First person that persecutes us a little bit. Well, I tried to witness to him. He turned around like bit my head off, man. A demon manifested when I was trying to witness to that guy. What? Mama. Guys, we got to get tough. We got to get serious.
The whole world is lost, man. Jeannie said, this is a crazy generation. They've all been crazy ever since Adam. They've been crazy. But my point is this, is that we have the authority. We have the power. We're committed. The gospel, which is the only power of God unto salvation. That's what was messing the Jews up. The apostles kept preaching a doctrine that said that Jesus Christ is Savior and Prince. He's the only Savior in the world. He's a healer. He's a deliverer. He's a repentance of sin. Only through Jesus Christ by the blood he resurrected from the dead. He ascended on high. We saw him take off into glory. He's seated at the right hand of God the Father, making intercessory for us. This Jesus that you killed is now alive, and 500 people have seen him as a witness. He resurrected from the dead, and then he came and appeared unto us, and we saw him in his resurrected body. Jesus is not dead. You didn't kill him. He's alive. He's alive. He's alive. And we're his witnesses. And then he sent the Holy Ghost to confirm it. And we're all filled with the Holy Ghost now, which is the power. That's why we have boldness. Grant unto your servants boldness that we may speak thy word. Are y'all alive in this place? Listen, let me tell you, and I'm coming to a close. If Rosh here, she can start to get ready. Here's the revelation tonight. We have got to be serious about Jesus Christ. We got to be serious about preaching the glorious gospel of Jesus. It's time to wake up, thou sleeping church. It's time to wake up. It's time to be serious about God. It's time to get aggressive. It's time to do something great for God. It's time to turn the world upside down for Jesus Christ and for his glory. It's time to pray. It's time to fast. It's time to witness. It's time to do something. Something for God. It's time to live for God. It's time to serve God with all of our hearts. We got to get over me. Man, the most ology that most people know is me-ology. Me. What about me? Hey, what about me? Me. What? Me. No, how about him? It's all about him, in him, in Christ, in whom. Look at the scripture. And every time you see him, you're there. You're in him. You're seated with him in heavenly places. All spiritual blessings in heavenly places have been given unto you in Christ Jesus. You are in Christ, and Christ is in you. His authority, his power, all authority in heaven and earth has been given unto Jesus. And now he's delegated that authority to the church. And we have the authority and power to transform and change the world. But we gotta wake up. We got to wake up. We got to get over us. We can't make life about us. And I'm not saying we don't take care of our families, because you got to work. A man that doesn't take care of his family is worse than the infidel and has denied the faith. Is what the Bible says. So you got to work. I'm not saying you don't take care of your family. What I'm saying is that you got to figure out what you were called to do. What has God called you to do? What is your purpose? What is your plan? Where do you fit in the body of Christ? What are your gifts? What are your talents? What in the world are you doing? Do 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 do. Anybody ever seen the Twilight Zone? Man, that's a weird show, man. Ooh. Ooh. Are y'all alive in this place? I mean, how many of you want to get delivered from Twilight Zone? Jesus. Some of you folks have probably done some stuff that puts you way out there dangling. Couple of years and you're just coming on in, baby. I mean, you know, they got some stuff that'll make you dangle. Jesus. How many of you know we want to be delivered from that kind of crazy stuff, man? We only want one power in our life, and that's Jesus, man. We only want one spirit, and that's the Holy Spirit in our lives, man. We don't want anything else, man. How many of you tired, man? Tired of going around the mountain, beat up, you quit. I'm glad you're dead. How long has it taken you to get to the end of yourself? How long has it taken you to get to the bottom? Where you finally look up and say, hey, God, I can't do this thing anymore. I quit. God says, great. I've been waiting for you to quit for years. I mean, you know, as long as you're still living and you're doing it your way and it's about you, God can't use you. Here's what God will do. He'll allow you to go through a little something, something. How many of you want to quit the something, something? Man, I just feel His glory. When we turn those lights down, let the Spirit of God just move in His place. Let God change you tonight. Just relax. Let the Spirit of God change you. Be a worshiper, not a performer. Never live your life for men. Only live your life for God. Never be a man pleaser. Always be a God pleaser. Never worry about what your neighbor's thinking about you because they really are not thinking about you. Imagine that.
Thank you. thank you for being with us. Holy Spirit, reveal Jesus to our hearts tonight. Reveal Jesus Christ to us. The one who hung on the cross for us. The one who shed his blood for us. The one who rose from the dead for us so that we can have hope. Reveal Jesus Christ to us, Holy Spirit. The sun sets free is free indeed. Lord, as we move into our first prayer focus, God, I thank you that you have set us free. Father, and we're praying for the supernatural move of the Holy Spirit upon the Independence Day celebration as we attempt to call attention to the importance of prayer and bring glory to God by forming the world's largest prayer circle. Father, what better day to bring the community together to glorify you than on our nation's Independence Day, Father? So I thank you for, first off, our freedom in you, Christ, and I thank you that we're free in this nation, Lord. And Lord, we are your people, and you have called us by name, so we're humbly coming before you and praying and seeking your face, Father, and we're rejecting anything that's not of you, anything that is wicked, Lord. We lay it down, Father. We lay it down. We lay it down, Lord, so that you will hear our prayers and you will forgive us of our sins and you'll restore our land, because our world, Lord, our whole world is hurting and is in need, Lord, and it's sick. And we need you, God. So I pray, Father, as you are with us on Independence Day, that everything will flow smoothly, Lord, that you would send people from all around this region, Lord. Get the word out about this prayer circle, Father. Send people from the north, the south, the east, the west, Father. Send them from all over the south, Lord, to join us for this celebration, Father, for fellowship and fun. But most importantly, Lord God, to bring glory to you, to come together to pray, Father. To you wholeheartedly, when we come into agreement together and we seek your face and we pray, we find you and you show up and you answer and you meet our every need. So I thank you ahead of time for meeting our needs for this nation and this world. I thank you that you are doing something in this place, in Miracle Place Church, in this region, in this nation, in this world, Father, something new, something fresh. And it all starts with our freedom that comes from Christ. So, Lord, I ask you, just like your word says, if we ask in your Son's name, if we ask anything in your Son's name, that it'll be done. So I'm asking you right now, in the name that's above all names, the names of Jesus, the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, that you move mightily on the hearts of your people, of your children, as they're drawn by your Holy Spirit here for our 4th of July celebration, our Independence Day celebration. Move on people's hearts, Father, that they would never be the same, that they won't just come for a show of fireworks, but they will get, even if they think they're coming for a show of fireworks, Lord, we know that they're going to get much more. So we're just thanking you ahead of time, because they're going to leave knowing the love Jesus Christ, knowing who Jesus Christ is, knowing that they encountered you, Father, because we're claiming it right now that every heart will be touched at this celebration, Lord. So we just thank you. We honor you. We love you, Lord. We praise you, Jesus.
Worshipers are what you're here for. We're here to worship you in everything we do. We're here to praise you and glorify you in all the things we do in every part of our lives. It's here just for your glory. You brought us here just for your glory and in the things that you have for us. Father, I just want to thank you for allowing me the ability in all of us, in our hands and our feet, just to worship you, because that is the reason why we're here, to worship you, to praise you, for musicians to rise up as they come in ready to play so that we can have the worshipers out there to truly walk and enjoy the things that you have for us. The watchmen to walk on the walls as they pray over the people that are not quite ready yet, so we can put a covering over them so they can stand ready for the time that they can walk in the anointing that you have in their lives. God, please just keep us going in a way that is truth of you, so we can seek you and find you in all the things we do. God, I just want to thank you and I love you.
True worshipers, make us true worshipers. Right now, we're going to meditate on the rapid fire prayer focus. We're joining together to pray for a spirit of revival and salvation, that it will break out like never before in our children's church, with our youth ministry, and among the young people across this region. And a special prayer request tonight comes from our friends at the International House of Prayer, that we would pray for wayward and backslidden children to return to the fold. So we're asking that you guys come up who want to join in with us and pray for this focus, that we would have revival among the youth. If you have a wayward child that has stepped away from the faith, it's time now to pray them back into the fold. We're praying for salvation of our young people, revival among our young people. Father, we just come tonight, Lord, praying from Joel chapter 2, verse 28. Lord, you promised us in your word that you will pour out your spirit upon all people, and that our sons and daughters will prophesy, and that the old men will dream dreams and the young men will see visions. And Father God, we just ask you tonight to go after the wayward, Father. Go after the fallen. Go after the lost, Father. Those who don't want to set foot in a church, God, I pray right now that your Holy Spirit would run swiftly. Visit them with dreams, Father God. Give them Holy Spirit visitations. Give them revelations of you, Father, and bring them back to you in Jesus' name.
Father, I just lift up this ministry, every single member of this ministry and this upcoming generation. Lord, I thank you for allowing me to be a part of this ministry as an integral part of the family and as an integral part of everything that goes on here, Lord Jesus. And as a part of this generation, a generation that's already marked itself as being chosen, a generation that's qualified itself as being one whom you are unreservedly pouring your spirit upon, O Lord. And I just lift up every single member of this ministry, especially those who consider themselves sons and daughters. Lord, I just ask that you would send your Holy Spirit to take them by the hand, to lead them to the truth of all matters concerning your gifts, especially the spirit of prophecy, Lord Jesus. Be with those who are showing special interest in developing the spirit of prophecy, Lord Jesus, and prophetic giftings, Lord. I pray right now a hedge of protection over their minds, that they be ultimately liberated in the freedom that comes with Christ Jesus and exploring new and adventurous avenues of prophecy, Lord. That they would not just chase after these things out of curiosity. They would not just look after these things because of popularity or the popular imagination, Lord Jesus, but they would find themselves developing a sincere desire for the greater giftings and make a personal and more earnest pursuit of love, Lord Jesus, that they would find themselves developing an earnest desire to seek prophetic giftings because their love for you draws these qualities out of them, Lord Jesus, that they would just want to testify more effectively about you, and that they would want the way with which they testify about you to ultimately change the lives of everyone they come in contact with. I pray these things in the precious and holy name of Jesus. Amen.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for rapid fire to hit our nation, our communities, and our church. We thank you, Heavenly Father, that in the spirit realm that you would target our youth. We thank you, Heavenly Father, for supernatural admonition and favor toward those who are wayward, those who have heard the truth, Lord God. We ask that the spirit of faith will rise up in them, Lord God. We ask you, Heavenly Father, that they will wear this world like a loose garment, dear God. We ask you, Heavenly Father, that you would create a hunger and a thirst in them, Father. We ask you, Lord God, for overnight victory. We ask you, Lord God, that you would bring them out of darkness into your marvelous light. We ask God that this you would do by your outstretched hands. We ask God that this would be an undeniable deliverance. We ask God that you would turn them from their wicked ways. We bless them to be born again. And all those who call upon your name, the name of the Lord thy God is a strong tower, and they who run into it, they are safe. Save us, God, and our youth. In Jesus' name, amen.
Lord, Father God, I pray for our church ministry and our youth ministry, Lord. I ask for you to just touch them, heal them, Lord. Just get them the right, correct mind to come to you, Lord, for anything that they are going through. And Lord, I pray for the children, Lord, that are struggling, Lord. They need you, Lord. Lord, we need you more than anything, Lord, because I know that the Bible says when there's more or two, or either without, that you will always be there to hear our cry, Lord. Lord, I ask for you to look down on every single last kid, the ministry, bless this ministry, Lord. Just give us a head of protection, Lord. Just seek and we shall find, Lord. Ask and it shall be given. Knock and a door will be open unto you, Lord. Because, Lord, I know I see many children that need you, Lord. And, Lord, just like Miss Rasha said, please bring them in, Lord. They are needing to be led to you like how I was, Lord. Lord, because I know that you say that we can't do nothing in this world without you. You are the way, the truth, and the light, Lord. You wake us up every morning, Lord. You put clothes on our backs, Lord. You make sure that we're singing on one accord, Lord. You're making sure that we waking up every morning doing your work, Lord, because can't nothing get done in this world without you, Lord. You are our mind, a mind regulator, a mind healer, and a redeemer, Lord. And Lord, I just ask you to set a fire for those young children that are in children's church, Lord, and for the kids that are in the youth ministry, Lord. Just bless them, Lord. Lift them up. Give them anything if they ask for, Lord, because you said if they ask, it shall be given. In Jesus' name I pray all these things unto you, Lord. Amen.
Father God, we come to you first and foremost to ask that you forgive us our sins as we humbly forgive those who sin against us, Father. Father, we thank you for a refiner's fire, Father God, for all of us adults and all of us youngsters, Father God. Devil, take your hands off our children. You have no authority over none of us. Father, you tell us whatever we bind in heaven is bound on earth. Whatever we loose in heaven is loosed in earth, Father God. And you went to heaven and through hell just for the keys. Devil, I bind and rebuke you and all your minion in Jesus' name. Because you have no power. You have no authority. And our children, we're standing in the gap right now for our children in Jesus' name. Father, I ask that you touch those who have fell away and listen to the devil. Because he is nothing. He'll never be nothing and he can never be nothing. Father, you are the great and almighty. Father, you are the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. Father God, we love you. We ask that you pour out your anointing to overfill all of us, Father God. Father, I ask that you start a wildfire, Father God. Father, because it's dry. Father, we ask for your anointing. Father, we love you, and we ask that you lead our footsteps. In Jesus' name, amen.
Lord, I just want to thank you right now, Jesus, for giving us our children's ministry, Lord, and all the wonderful children that we have at our church right now. I want to thank you for the leaders that you've given us in our youth ministry, Lord, and I just want to ask that you anoint them, Lord, and that you fill them with your wisdom, Lord, and you give them the words to say to be able to grow our children and our children's church up into awesome men and women of God, Lord. And I just want to ask you to draw the children to you, Lord, children that aren't here, Lord. Put it in their hearts to know Jesus, Lord. Put it on their hearts to be able to learn the things that Jesus can teach them so that way they can have a better future for themselves, Lord. And I just want to ask that you put a hedge of protection around all of the ones that can't be here, Lord, because their parents haven't taught them, Lord. And just put a yearning in their parents' heart to lead them if they don't even come to church, just to bring their children here, Lord, so that way they can know. In Jesus' name, amen.
Yeah.
Again, we continue our rapid fire prayer focus tonight. We're praying briefly for a revival in our children's church and salvation of children.
I pray for the children that believe in God now that they don't believe in God. Amen.
Children back to your heart that were lost. In Jesus' name, amen.
God, I pray for the children that don't believe in Jesus, that they come in this church and come for Jesus. Amen.
Amen. Good job.
Come on. Lord God, I just pray for all the children out there that don't have your love, and I just pray that you just spread it out to them, Lord God. Amen.
I pray for the enemies at school, and I pray that they can ask Jesus for their life. And I pray that they can get better. Amen.
I pray for the homeless, sick, and hurt so they can be lifted up to Jesus.
Amen. I pray that other children that are lost get saved.
For the people that are sick to get better.
Lord, I specifically pray for Miss Pam's son, Terrell Ventrine, Father, that you would bring him back to your heart, Lord, that you would remove the anger that is in his heart. And for every person that's in here tonight, Father, for their children, if they might have been saved before, Father, but they went astray and they left you for a moment, Father, we're calling them back into the kingdom right now in the name of Jesus. So, Lord, draw them with your spirit. Bring them back to your heart. Set them free and break the bondages that's holding them down and take the veil that is deceiving them off of their eyes and let them see your light, Jesus.
Father God, in the name of Jesus Christ, we're praying, Lord God Jesus, for the children, Lord God Jesus, the one that are lost, Lord God Jesus, the one that think they're unwanted. Father God, children just want to be loved and accepted, Lord. But you, Lord God Jesus, you loved them before they were even formed, Lord God Jesus. I thank you for that, Lord God Jesus. Let them know, Lord God Jesus, they are loved, they are wanted, they are special, Lord God Jesus. Put the anointing upon them, Lord God Jesus, that they know, Lord God Jesus, that you are the one that keeps them, Lord God Jesus, and holds them, Lord God Jesus, because they are royal priesthood. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I say amen.
I was reading in the Word the other day about when Jesus was in the garden, and when the disciples came to him in the garden, they said, "Well, Lord, should we take up the sword?" And then it says the scripture right next to it. It says he struck the high priest's servant and cut off his right ear. And it kind of reminded me that just like us, or just like them, that's us, a wretched man that we are, Lord. When the rubber meets the road, sometimes we go in reverse. But thank God that you are with us. Yes. And remind the children and inspire the teachers of the children that they're your children and that you love them. And no matter what we've been through, no matter what we go through, and no matter how many times we fall down, it is our will to get back up, and it is your will to lift us up. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name, amen.
Father God, I come to you tonight in prayer, thanking you for all you've done for us. But Father, when we see the news tonight and we see that the Supreme Court is going debating over some silly subjects about gay marriage, Lord, we should line up church and talk about saving our children and having church service on the courthouse steps, because our children need to have that type of nourishment in their souls, and we need to have that type of church every Sunday, every day. And maybe, just maybe, our state would not be in the state of affairs that it's in. Lord, our children need that type of nourishment. They need to know about Jesus and about God and about God's lovingness. And no matter how, like Ricky said, Bishop said, no matter how down far they've gone, that when they get done with themselves, that they look up and their loving God is there, and their hand stretches out to them, that God's loving hand is going to reach down and pick them up every single time. And I am a testament of that, because I have a paper in my hand that when I reneged on a promise to God, I just got notified that the state is not going to take my precious child away from me. And I did, and I have remained faithful to God. I've remained faithful to you, Lord, and I have read your word, and I have not wavered in giving you the glory, Lord, and I have not wavered once or blamed you or the devil. Every time he's coming to me, into my head, I have stomped you, and I've asked you to give him another black eye, dear Jesus. And that's what our youth need to know, and that's what they need to see, to follow in the show. Following the crowd is not worth it, that sometimes you need to separate from the pack, because God's always, always, always God's got your back. Thank you, Jesus.
Dear Lord God in heaven, I'm not a child anymore myself. I've grown up, I've become a man. And when children look, they see us as men and women. When they listen, they hear us as men and women. And I pray that you'll put it on every man and woman of God's heart to act like men and women of God, so that that's what these children will see and what they will hear. And I have been guilty, Lord, and I ask for forgiveness, that I might be a man of God to be an example for the young people in this world. In Jesus' name, amen.
Holy Father, Holy Jesus, Holy Spirit, I seek you in prayer for the youth of this ministry. I pray that you'll make them hungry, make them thirsty, and make them come to you. And I seek prayer for all the backsliders and everyone in this ministry, that you just make them hunger and thirst, Father God. Rain down in them, Father God, your Holy Spirit, your love, your blessing. And if there's any darkness in any of the youth, I just pray that you remove it from them, Father God. Let them see the light. Let them burn bright, Holy. In Jesus' likeness and name, I just pray that this prayer will come back full of love and joy and glory. Amen.
Deliverance from my enemies, too long.
unity within our church family and within the body of Christ. Ephesians 4:3. Make every effort to keep yourselves united in the Spirit, binding yourselves together with peace. John 17, verses 20 through 23. I am praying not only for these disciples, but also for all who will ever believe in me through their message. I pray that they will all be one, just as you and I are one. As you are in me, Father, and I am in you. And may they be in us so that the world will believe you sent me. I have given them the glory you gave me, so they may be one as we are one. I am in them, and you are in me. May they experience such perfect unity that the world will know that you sent me, and that you love them as much as you love me. Father, we thank you for the Church of Miracle Place. We thank you, Heavenly Father, for the miracle of unity. We ask, God, that you bind us together in the power of peace and unity. We ask, Father, for a holy conviction upon our church, Lord God. We ask, Heavenly Father, that no one would have to be asked to change or even taught to change. We ask for an anointing that would bring supernatural change and deliverance, God. You said, Lord God, that they will know us because of the love that we show for one another. So I ask, God, that every bond of love in this church will be strengthened. Every relationship that you have given us, Lord God, it will be perfected, and it shall endure every test and every assignment, Lord God. I ask, Heavenly Father, that we shall come through as gold, Father. We thank you that your word has been tested and has been tried, Lord God. We thank you that we are the church of the Latter-day Harvest, Lord God. We ask, Heavenly Father, that you would shine a light down from heaven above. We ask, God, that we would be that candle that cannot be hid, Lord God. We pray that Miracle Place Church would shine all over the world, Lord God, from the furthest corners of the earth, from the north, the south, the east, and the west, from the highways to the byways, from the lowest places to the highest places, Lord God. We ask, Heavenly Father, that there would be a voice, a cry from this place that will reach heaven. We ask you, Lord God, that as we bind together in unity, the angels of God would encamp themselves around about us. We praise you that each one will become ministers of flaming fires. We praise you, Lord God, for the spirit of a servant, Lord God. We thank you for the spirit of an intercessor, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, in this season for the spirit of a worshiper, Lord God. For the Father seeketh such to worship him. God, pour out your spirit upon us that we might worship you in spirit and in truth. Bless us to love you, Lord God. Bless us love for you to be strengthened, Lord God, and your love for us to be manifested. We promise to give you the praise, God. In the name of Jesus, amen.
focus number 4, that the Holy Spirit will instill a burning desire in the hearts of our church members to encounter God and get to know Him on a more intimate level through fasting and prayer. The scripture reads, "Sing to Him, yes, sing His praises. Tell everyone about His wonderful deeds. Exalt in His holy name, rejoice you who worship the Lord. Search for the Lord and for His strength, continually seek Him. That is why the Lord says, turn to me now while there is time. Give me your hearts, come with fasting, weeping, and mourning." Lord Jesus, I come before you right now, God, asking you that you would bind this church in the spirit of unity, and that you would place on our hearts a desire to draw closer to you through fasting and prayer. Lord, that you would raise up individuals to take it upon themselves to take a fast day, to seek you more in the prayer room, God. Lord, I ask that you would strengthen the heart and mind of the bishop, Lord, as he enters into the prayer room, God, that you would give him the vision and the direction for this church, and that we would stand behind him as church members, God, and that we would decrease so that you would increase, and that your perfect will would be orchestrated at Miracle Place Church, that as we lift you up, you would begin to draw all men unto you, Lord, that they would come from everywhere, God, Lord, wanting to see what's going on over here in Baker, Louisiana. We thank you, give you the praise, the glory, and the honor in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Great God in heaven, Lord, we just thank you for what came about tonight, Lord. Thank you for everyone and many prayers, Lord, because we give you the honor, we give you the glory, and we give you the praise, because it's all about you, Lord, and we thank you for being our Father, Lord. And Lord, we forever thanking you for your Son, Lord, that you gave to us, Lord, your grace and your mercy, Lord. We forever thanking you, Lord, for the shedded blood that he made a way for us, Lord, and we forever thank you for your Holy Spirit. I would always give references to your Trinity, Lord, because you are all in all, Lord. And Lord, we thank you. We thank you for the many prayers that came up tonight, Lord, and we know that your word would not return back void, Lord. Lord, it's all about you, Lord. Lord, we bless each and every one that came in tonight, Lord, and your word say you want us blessed all the time. Blessed coming in, blessed going out. Blessing the lying down, blessing the raising up, blessing the field, bless out the field, Lord. Lord, we thank you. We can't never stop saying thanking you, Lord, because you are all in all, Lord. And we ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.
We're going to close out tonight with small group prayer. And our small group prayer focus tonight on the scripture that we're praying is that God would lead us by his truth and teach us, because he's the God who saves us, and we will put our hope in him. So we're going to join together. You guys stand up. If God's done something for you, if he's done anything at all for you, stand to your feet and begin to worship him. Find a brother or a sister in need and begin to pray with them. Share your needs and cast your cares before God and join with one another in prayer. See the salvation of the Lord.